My esteemed listeners, in this tutorial, we bring out another famous algorithm design strategy, namely the greedy algorithm design strategy. In societal circles, we see a tough opposition for greed. Greed is not always desirable. It is not at all desirable anyway. Because greed keeps men forever poor, big mouthfuls often choke, never drop the bone to catch the shadow. A greedy person and a pauper are particularly one and the same. These are all some of the ideologies or some of the thoughts about the ill effects of greed. But in algorithmic circles, interestingly, we see greed playing the role. We will find here and there proponents of greed. They would say, greed always exists for a reason. Greed is good. Embrace it, love it, and leave it, and solve the problem. Okay? Greed, for a lack of a better word, is good. Greed is right. Greed works. This is what Michael Douglas, the US actor in the role of Gordon Gekko, in the film Wall Street, which was released during 1987, has to say. The famous actor, US actor. Anyway, without much ado, we will see how exactly the greed plays the role in solving the problems in algorithmic circles. And what exactly is this greed? And I think we have seen greedy algorithm playing its role in while we saw DFS, depth first search traversal of a graph. Okay, because it is not greed, because we will backtrack and we will go back and we will see whether our solutions are correct, whether we have entered, whether we have left out any of the vertices, and if we have left out, we will go back and we will just once again number that. As far as BFS is concerned, we never backtrack. Okay, sitting at a place, we will cover all the directly connected vertices and then we will jump to the next vertices two edges apart. We have seen greedy algorithms already in terms of breadth first search, but anyway, we never spelt out that it is greedy algorithm which is playing its role, because there the discussion point was something different. It is decrease and conquer. And here we will quote a very famous example or maybe a benchmark problem, which is called change making problem. In societal circles, we have also seen a vendor having all denominations at his discrete. And if we go with, let us say, 2000 rupees notes, and if we ask him, he will stretch out 5,500 rupees notes and he will give it to us. Even if we are wanting to find some other lower denominations of the currency so that we can just pay for the paltry, the buying activity that we must have done with a vegetable vendor or milk vendor, etc. There we need a change, but anyway, it is not gotten because of the greed that this particular vendor has. Even though he has all denominations, he will never spare out the lower denominations because he wants to keep it with him for possible use in the forthcoming days or forthcoming time. Anyway, we will solve this problem by greedy technique, and it will give us an optimal solution, and we will write an algorithm for this also. We have denominations D1 greater than D2 greater than D3 greater than D4. If 2000 rupees as far as Indian rupees are concerned, Indian currency is concerned, 2000 rupees is greater than 500 rupees, 500 rupees is greater than 200, 100, something like that. And we will also use this greedy technique in developing minimum spanning trees out of a weighted graph. And we will also solve single source shortest path problem by using greedy algorithm. And we will also solve Huffman trees. We will develop Huffman trees, which is widely used for compression, image compression, and removing redundancy, representing a paragraph in natural language processing and elsewhere, wherever compression or efficient use of the memory space is required, we use Huffman technique. which is typically playing its role in particularly in compression, okay, image compression to say the least. And we will take up this greedy algorithm and we will explain this. Okay, algorithm change, we have total amount represented by AM and we have currency denomination starting from 1 to N. Okay, so here it could be 200. So in this particular circle, in order to trace this algorithm, we will take this example, 200 rupees, 100 rupees, 20, 10. Okay, 50, 20 and 10. 200, 100, 50, 20 and 10. Okay. Implements the greedy algorithm for the change making problem. What it does? Input a non-negative integer amount AM and a decreasing array of coin denomination CD. Okay, something like this. Output an array C 1 to N of the number of currencies of each denominations in the change or no solution message. So for I equal to 1 to total amount, do. Okay, we'll take an example of total amount equal to 2750 rupees, 2750, and the first denomination is 200. Okay, therefore CFI, what CFI gets is, okay, the number of denominations of 200, let us say, number of denominations of 200. So it is total amount 2750 divided by 200. This gives us 13 point something. Since it is floor, we will be satisfied with 13. What goes over here is 13. So 13 twos are 2600. Then in order to get the balance amount, what we do is amount is modularly, okay, this is, we will do a modular division over here, amount mod CDFI. So amount is 2050 mod 200, what we get is 150 as the remainder. Okay, so now AM becomes 150. It will once again go, because AM is not equal to 0, it will go once again. Therefore, 150 CDFI, CDF2 is 100. So 150 by 100 will give us 1. Okay, and 150 mod 100 will give us 50. So what amount will become 50? So 50 will go once again in the iteration. So 50 by 50, we will get just 1. Just 1. 50. So what remains is 1. 100 rupees note 1. And what remains is 50. And 50 divided by 50 will get us 0. Therefore, amount will become 0. Okay. We'll go back. So therefore, in this C array, what we get is 13 rupees, 200 rupees notes, 100 rupees note, and 150 rupees note. Okay, this is for a typical example. What we have written here is, okay, typical example. We'll just remove that. Anyway, right. So what we have this in this C array is, as far as this example is concerned, C will have 13, C of 0 equal to 13, that is 13 denominations of 200 rupees and 1 denomination of 100 rupees and 1 denomination of, let us say 50 rupees, that's all. Okay, it contains. Okay, if amount equal to 0, upon this division and modular division, if amount turns out to be 0, yes, it turns out to be 0 when we try to divide it by 50, okay, when we try to do the operation by 50, so here it becomes 0, okay, this becomes 1, and 50 mod 50 becomes 0. Okay, it becomes 0, we will return C array, this array will go, this is the solution, else we will find no solution. Can we give an example for this change making problem where there is no solution? Yes, here it is. This is one of the examples of many examples we encounter in our mundane life. Okay, example situation, change making problem which doesn't work. Here is one of the many such instances. For we have a total denomination of, let us say, 200 rupees. We have 200 rupees with us. Okay, this is the amount. Okay, 200 rupees is the amount, total amount we have, let us say. This is not D1. And we have D1, 50 denomination, and D2, 10 rupees. okay, 10 rupees. D3, we have three denominations, sorry, two denominations of 10, one denomination of 50, okay, and amount is, let us say, 200 rupees, one denomination, okay, so sorry, two denominations, okay, I will just rewrite this, okay, there is a little confusion over here, okay, we'll just avoid this confusion anyway, okay. Right, what we have with us is one denomination of 200 rupees, two denominations of 50 rupees, three denominations of 100 rupees. Three denominations of 100 rupees. And we have an amount equal to 100 rupees. Therefore, for this, what we get is one note of 50 rupees, one note of 50 rupees, and three notes of three denominations of 10 rupees. So 10 into 3 becomes 30. And 50. 50 plus 30 equal to 80. We never get back the total change for 100 rupees. The actual solution is actually, okay, two notes of, just not four notes, two notes of denomination 50. Okay, what we have is only one note of 50. I told you, okay, this is the, in the decreasing order, what we have is one note of 50, okay, one note of 200, one note of 50, and three notes of 10, okay, three notes of 10 we have, three notes of 10, one notes of 50, so 50 plus 30 becomes 80, we never get the change, complete change, and though there is a 200 note which is available with the vendor, it is useless, we never get the solution. Right, spanning trees. A spanning tree of a connected graph is its connected acyclic subgraph that contains all the vertices of a graph. Okay, it is possible to draw n to the power of n minus 2 such subgraphs for a fully connected graph. Okay, this is a graph because it has cycles over here, and a tree is an acyclic graph, as you know, the fundamental definition of a tree. Okay, that means from a vertex to vertex, there exists one and only one path. But here between vertex to vertex, there are several paths. Therefore, it becomes a graph. So, all trees are graphs. All graphs are not trees. This also we have proved in our previous tutorials. So, now, for a given connected, fully connected graph, so every vertex is connected to other vertex. Therefore, this is a fully connected graph. There is a rule that n to the power of n minus 2 subgraphs, okay, for a fully connected graph can be drawn, which can be called as spanning trees. We can draw, let us say, for this particular graph, which is fully connected, we can draw, there are 4 vertices, it is 4 minus 2, okay, 4 to the power of 2, it is 4 square, 4 square is 16. We can draw 16 spanning trees as far as this graph is concerned. Okay? Right, now we will just move. We will see how exactly we can draw this, right? So, we'll go on. You just kindly watch this. See, this is one spanning tree. This is another spanning tree. Okay, right. This is another spanning tree. So, 4 are covered. This is the other way of drawing spanning trees. And this is the other way. Right. This is another spanning tree. So 16 spanning trees we drew. Right, 16 spanning trees. Therefore, if there are 4 vertices, 4 vertices, 3 edges are enough. 3 edges are enough. But all the 4 vertices are connected, and there exists one and only one path between every other vertices, between any 2 vertices selected at random. Therefore, this becomes a spanning tree. Okay, to span means to wide open. That is a meaning of spanning. Okay, anyway, we will go to minimum spanning tree. So, this terminology minimum spanning tree is applicable only for connected weighted graphs. There should be some weights indicated. The weight could be distance, the weight could be discharge, the weight could be effort involved, the weight could be energy consumed between this event and this event, or whatever. They are not mere numbers in our practical life. In the real world example, they connote something connected to real world problem. So a minimum spanning tree of a connected weighted graph is its spanning tree of smallest weight where the weight of a tree is defined as the sum of the weights of all its edges. So if this is the tree, this is the graph involving four vertices, and these are all the weights indicated, and I can draw several spanning trees out of this for this, but the minimum spanning tree is this. A to B, 3 units, and A to C is 4 units, and B to D is 2 units. All the vertices are connected by just 3 edges. Now, the minimum spanning tree has a weight equal to 4 plus 3 plus 2. 4 plus 3 plus 2, that is 9 units. 9 units of anything, okay, which is specific to the problem. This is how, and there are algorithms which will help us to arrive at such a spanning tree. Okay, now we will take this example, Prim's algorithm, we'll take to solve minimum spanning tree problem. This is example number one. So Prim's algorithm selects the first vertex at random, and usually it is a vertex which will have a number which is in the priority line. Okay, if it is numbered like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, the vertex numbered with 1 will be selected. And if it is labeled with A, B, C, D, that is alphabets, then the vertex A will be selected. Okay, A will be selected, and it will look around, and it will just list directly connected vertices. It will make a list of directly connected vertices, and the vertices which are not directly connected, it will assume the distance to be infinity. Therefore, it will select the vertex, the algorithm will select the vertex from the beginning vertex, which is very nearer to the beginning vertex. Then it will find out other vertices which are connected to both A as well as B. And among them, only the vertices which have shorter distances will be selected. So we'll go through this example to really understand this particular algorithm. So we'll start from A. Okay, since this is the starting vertex, it is not connected to any other vertex, and the distance also we don't know. There is no question of mentioning the distance also. Therefore, dash and dash is indicated. Okay, B is connected to A, remaining vertices. So A is already out. So A is one of the vertices in the spanning tree. Okay, so B is connected to A with a distance of 2. C is also connected to A with a distance of 4. D is connected to A with a distance of 3. E is not connected to A, therefore distance could be infinity. F is also not connected to A, therefore distance could be infinity. And here we will just explain how exactly this, as the algorithm goes by iteration, how exactly the spanning tree will be developed. So this is selected, right? Next, B, A2 will be selected. I think you must have noticed here, this is to be selected because this has minimum distance. Therefore, this will be selected for the next cycle. So B will be joining the tree vertices, spanning tree vertices. So now we have already two vertices joined into the vertices kitty. Okay, they have come to the vertices group. Okay, so what remains here is C, which has a distance of from A to 4 units of distance or 4 units of weight from A. C is connected to A. D is also connected to A with a weight equal to 3. E is connected to B because B is already selected, B with 5 units. And F is neither connected to A nor to B. Therefore, it is not connected to any one among the selected vertices. Therefore, the distance is infinity. And we have to choose over here this one only. So D, A, comma 3 will be selected. So D, A, comma 3 will be selected. So now we have in the vertex set, A included, B included, now D included. So D will come like this. So spanning tree is growing, it's evolving. So now C, A, 4. C is connected to A with a distance of 4. E is connected to D because D has come. E is connected to D with a distance of 4. F is connected to D with a distance of 1. Therefore, we need to, earlier it was infinity, now with the addition of D, F will find some kind of a connection. Okay, right. So this will be selected. So F will be selected. Okay, so F will come and join the vertex set, the vertex that forms the spanning tree with a distance of 1. Then C is selected. C has already come over here. Then what remains is E. E has a distance of 4. from D, therefore that will also be selected. So the tree vertices are exhausted and all the vertices are connected by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 minus 1, 5 edges. And the spanning tree, minimum spanning tree is 2 plus 4 plus 3 plus 4 plus 1. You add all the weights and what we get is 14 units. This is mentioned as units because it could be anything. Okay, it could be cost, it could be effort, or it could be whatever. Very specific to the problem. And we have another example, A, B, C, D, E. There are 5 vertices, therefore the spanning tree needs only 4 edges. 4 edges to build the spanning tree. So we will start from A. It is not connected to anything, any other vertex, because that is the beginning vertex, and the distance also we don't know. So B is connected to A with a distance of 5, E is connected to A with distance of 2. Okay, the writings over here has the reference of this particular figure. So C is connected to A. Of course, the algorithm will take the clue from the weight matrix, that we should remember, and the connectivity is gotten for the algorithm through adjacency matrix. Okay, so weight matrix is also an indication of adjacency matrix, because in the weight matrix we will mention, as our respected viewers will recall, weight matrix will have the direct connection weights. Therefore, this is availed from a weight matrix. So E, A2, C is connected to A with a 7 distance, D is not connected to A, therefore it is not connected to A, and the distance could be infinity. So here this will be selected because it has the shortest distance. Then we have 2 vertices added to the spanning tree vertices, and B is connected to A with a distance of 3. Okay, B was connected to A before with a distance of 5. With the inclusion of E, okay, the distance reduced. You should notice this point. So D is connected to E with distance 5 and C is connected to E with distance 4. Therefore, this should be selected. So this will be added to the vertex set. It will come over here. And what remains is D, E, 5, C, E, 4. Okay, C is connected to E with 4 as the unit distance, Therefore, this will be selected and joined, and it will be unioned with the vertex sets. Vertex set E, 4, and what remains is D of C, 4, and that will be included. And all the vertices are exhausted, and this is how spanning tree develops. And the minimum spanning tree is 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 4, that will get us 13 units. Okay, now we will write the algorithm, Prim's algorithm. So what it does is it constructs the minimum spanning tree by implementing Prim's algorithm. Input, a weighted connected graph. Okay, graph is set of 2 sets. One is vertex set, other one is edge set. Okay, output is minimum spanning tree set of edges comprising minimum spanning tree of G. Okay, so we will initialize the vertex set with V0, initialization of vertex set with any vertex set. We have selected A in both the examples that we discussed. So VT will go with a set vertex A, as far as that examples are concerned. MST, minimum spanning tree, is yet to be developed, therefore it is equal to 0. It is initialized to 0. Now, for I equal to 1 to cardinality of V minus 1, because if number of vertices are 4, then what are the, how many edges we need? We need only 3 edges. If number of vertices are 7, we need only 6 edges. 1 is also included and 6 is also included. Therefore, 1 to 6, 1 to 4, 1 to 3, something like that. Okay, now find a minimum weight edge E, okay, from among, okay, which is called as V star and U star, which is V star and U star. This is not there, of course. Okay, find a minimum edge E, V star, U star, among all edges V and U, connected with V and U, V is a vertex name and U is also a vertex name. We have chosen those kind of vertices where V star U star is an edge which has the minimum weight, such that V is in MST, V is already gone to MST because it is all selected over here, and U is in V minus MST because U is available in the vertex set and V is already selected. Therefore, it is V minus MST, right? MST equal to VT vertex set, okay, which is V0, the beginning, that is A union some other vertex, A union B, maybe A union C, whatever the distance is, or whichever the edge which maintains small distance and which is connected to V. That is the thing, which is connected to A. So A to B may be the minimum distance. Here U star is B and VT is A. Something like this. MST equal to MST union E star. Okay, E star, okay, has got over here. MST equal to MST union E star. Return MST. I think here we have made a small mistake, I suppose. Here it is VT actually. Okay, VT is earlier VT, which contained nothing, plus union U star, okay, that is A. And MST is, for MST minimum, for any edge we need two vertices, therefore MST is MST, okay, which contains zero, union E star is that edge with minimum distance. So E star is that edge with minimum distance, therefore star is given. Okay, among all the edges connected to A, this is the edge which has minimum distance. It may be AE, it may be AF, it may be AG, something like that. It need not be AB always. Okay, so this is done iteratively up to V minus 1 times. If number of vertices are N, if number of vertices are 6, this algorithm will be executed only for 5 number of times. Okay, so we will return MST. So by that time MST will have collected a collection of edges with minimum weights. Okay, you can try yourself. Okay, this is left to our respected viewers. Okay, you can try this. Okay, starting from A. Okay, you can just go on listing. And to me it appears there is nothing like listing other vertices, all the other vertices. You start with A anyway. A, B is connected to A, okay, B comma 2, okay, and then C is connected to A, it is, C comma 3, and D is connected to A, it is 4 comma, D comma 4, like this, whatever it is collected, and among them you select, okay, A, B will be selected, so B will also be coming in the set of vertices. So B will have connectionality with other edges, other vertices. That's how we are going to build the edges of the spanning tree by concentrating on vertices. Okay, vertices are added to the set, vertex set. Simultaneously, the edges are also built. Therefore, Prim's algorithm is vertex oriented, but it is greedy because once the decision is taken, it will never backtrack. Okay, we will answer two important questions with our understanding on greedy algorithm technique or Prim's algorithm. Can Prim's algorithm be applied to a connected graph with no weights? No, it is not possible because it carries no meaning. But anyway, if at all we want to invent or we want to apply Prim's algorithm, or we are hell-bent on application of Prim's algorithm, we can just treat all the weights to be one. And we will go ahead. So any spanning tree should hold good because it contains no weights. It is as good as, because Prim's algorithm demands weights, therefore we will add one to all the other edges and we will just implement the Prim's algorithm. But anyway, it becomes very primitive application. Can we do with any other algorithm for such a graph to generate spanning tree? Yes, DFS is the best algorithm. Starting from a vertex, we will just develop what is called as, I think my respected viewers should recall, we have generated what is called as DFS tree. Okay, while traversing in the mealy, we have also developed DFS tree. This DFS tree is nothing but the spanning tree. Okay, so DFS algorithm is applied and DFS tree generated, and DFS tree is nothing but the spanning tree. Okay, now this is the best algorithm to develop the spanning tree, if at all the graph that is available to us is doesn't comprise of any weights. I think we have completed the explanation of Prim's algorithm and change making problem as two examples of the algorithms that are developed using greedy strategy. So a very important point to be highlighted is greedy algorithms will never backtrack. They will take the decision. Okay, once the decisions are taken, that is the final and ultimate decision. So with this, we will close this session, and we will come up with the other algorithms in our next tutorial. Until